Did you know that you could turn your residential backyard vegetable garden into a market garden? Today, we have County Extension Director Richard Tyson here talking to us about the market. How are you, Richard?
Good, thank you, Amy. It's good to be here.
Great. So we're here to talk about backyard gardens and marketing gardens. So what's the difference between the two?
Well, a home garden, normally you're growing enough vegetables for a family of 2 to 4 or maybe 6 people. If you're going to make it large enough where you're going to be able to sell enough produce where you can pay for your vegetables and have a little money extra, it's going to need to be at least twice as big. So that's the main difference. And you're going to have to look at it a little bit different because you have to look at what products people are buying. So you go to the store, you look at the size, the quality of things that are being sold in the store, and most importantly, you look at the price. And that is the price that, you know, probably the top price you're going to be able to get is the retail price in the grocery store. So then when you go back to your garden, you produce everything thinking about it from a marketing standpoint instead of your kitchen.
Sure. Yeah, that sounds nice to make some mm-hmm. money off the vegetables. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So what are some different advantages that you have financially? I know you spoke about that, but also
sure.
health-wise.
Well, healthy living, obviously. You want to get outdoors. You want to exercise, you know, get some fresh air and that sort of thing. But I think the most important health aspect is the nutritional aspect and the environmental aspect of growing your own fruits and vegetables 20 feet from your kitchen versus having them shipped 3,000 feet or more, whether they're grown in California, Mexico, or South America. And it usually takes about 2 weeks for them to make it through that marketing chain. They get dropped off at different warehouses and distribution centers before they actually get to the grocery store. So what you're producing in your backyard and selling in the market, farmers market, is produce that's been harvested that day. As a matter of fact, these were all harvested this morning out of our exploration gardens at the extension office, along with this vertical system that we were growing Swiss chard in. Now, if you were selling for a market garden at a farmer's market, you would be harvesting Swiss chard at a much smaller stage, about like this, and rather than letting it get mature like that. Another example is right here. These were all grown hydroponically, and these were purchased in the store.
Great, so you would usually harvest at this state?
Well, that smaller stage, definitely smaller stage than this right here.
Great. All right. Are there legal requirements? Is it legal to sell this?
It's very important to follow the legal requirements. If you're in a residential neighborhood and you have a neighborhood association, obviously you have to follow their rules. But if you're in an unincorporated county residential area, then it's legal to have a market garden as long as you sell them off-site. So you can't sell okay. from your home. But as long as you take the produce to a farmer's market, sell off-site, you're good. Most farmer's markets, or say churches that have events where you can sell things, not necessarily the church, but the farmer's market will usually require a business license. There's a few that don't. Audubon Park Farmer's Market in Orlando, if you're a local grower and get inspected by the market manager, does not require a business license. But generally, it's probably the best good idea to go ahead and get a business license from the county.
Okay, and when you're talking about the county, are you talking specifically about Orange County or the surrounding areas?
It could be any county that you live in, but Orange County obviously is where our extension office is. So that's, and if you're selling in Orange County, then that's where
sure.
you would want to get your business license. All you have to do is go in and ask for a license that allows you to sell whole produce at farmers markets, and they'll issue you the correct license.
Well, thank you so much for being here, Richard. This all looks really great, nice and fresh and healthy.
Thank you, Amy. That was great. Appreciate it.
And now you know how you can turn your backyard vegetable garden into a backyard market garden.